long have you been playing the hurdy-gurdy?
A little over a year.
A little over a year, okay. Is it true that Tom's making a movie about you?
I don't know.
Is that Auntie Bobo walking in the door? Auntie Bobo, everybody, give her a round of applause. Just when you thought there weren't enough nacho lighters to go around, Auntie Bobo walks in with a whole case of nacho lighters. What's a nacho lighter? She's going to explain it to you later in our program. Thanks for coming, all four of you. This is terrific.
Yeah!
I was sort of hoping nobody would show so we could get the hell out of here right away. But if we can thin the herd at the top of the show by putting some rough acts on and get this thing down to about two people, we'll be in good shape. So let's see how it goes. What a sad day today. Anybody that woke up and saw that Paul Rubens, a.k.a. Pee-wee Herman, has left us for bigger shores. Did you hear that story? Did I ruin your day? Pee-wee Herman, he was so funny. Here's what I say. Rest in peace, Paul Rubens. Pee-wee Herman, live forever. Because you can still dial him in on the old cable. Everybody know what a cable is? Why, that's an old thing that go into your house and you put the TV on. You can on demand get your programs and all that you can do. Ah, shit. All right, at this point, the show will be going downhill. It was a good start, but I haven't had sleep. I haven't had enough to drink. Let's do some crowd work. How you guys doing? Great. All right, we got that out of the way.
Goddamn.
Hang on. Just when you think I don't have things, I got something up my sleeve for you. This will get you going. How about that? There is not one other open mic show within a stone's throw of this bar that gives you free bubbles. And like I say, I get these at the dollar store. It says they're scented, but if it turns out they only smell like plastic, like the container they come in. That's what you get for a dollar. They're supposed to be grape. We did dose them with acid, though, so if you want to catch some of these in your mouth, this show will get a lot better real quick. Just saying.
Or worse.
That's enough. I'm drinking a delicious beer. It's like I said earlier, it tastes like somebody's pissing in your mouth. What's this beer? What's that called again? Florida, right?
It's called pissing in your mouth.
Florida beer. Fingers. You know, that's what Florida tastes like. Why shouldn't the beer taste that way? I like Florida where I go and where I am. I like it. The few places I go have remarkable diversity, and they're very, you know, pretty chill, you know. We all laughed at Pee-wee. Doesn't matter what side of the fence you're on, except for Scumbag. No, I'm not going to say it. I'm sorry. I should be nice. I like all people, except for murderers and, you know, terrible people. Oh, did I mention this is a church? It is. We're totally legit. Everybody in our cast has been ordained at the Universal Life Church as a minister, except for Michael, who I think, what are you, Hasidic? What's wrong with you?
I belong to a very ancient tradition.
You belong to an ancient tradition? All right. Well, we better get some entertainment up here quick. This thing's going south. You're in the front row? It's a splash zone. Oh, okay.
All right.
I also have the bubbles in stereo, in case anyone was wondering.
Oh, dude.
Most people have monophonic bubbles. I get it in stereo. See? Get it from both sides. Pretty good, huh?
Yeah.
Doesn't it make you feel like you just imploded in a small can-like submarine? Have you seen this one? All your money went. Doesn't that feel good? All right, fine.
It's great. I love it.
I told you I'm not a comedian, I'm a performance artist. I don't do any jokes. All right, I'm going to do the turning off of this microphone because it's already going south. Are those new batteries you put out for me? Daryl, you are a sweetheart. Daryl gave me new batteries for the microphones, everybody. While we play the welcome song,
I'm going to change the batteries for your entertainment.
Great job, Daryl. Change the batteries.
Impressed yet? It's a funny comedian out here, but I'm going to hold because you want a crowd, right? Or they won't laugh. Aren't you a comedian? Isn't that you? Yeah. You're that guy. You're funny. You're funny as hell. All right. Thanks, sir. Give him a round of applause.
Next week he's going to do a shorter type set. By the way, it wasn't the batteries. This mic's just fucked. But luckily, don't worry, I happen to have another microphone.
I changed all the cotton on it just now, so it sounds
like... Backup mic. You want to see that and see what you think?
Because it's supposed to cushion the wheel against the
screen. See if you... We have somebody who knows what they're doing with sound here. The Naked Poets here, everybody. Give them a round of applause. We're so happy that you're here. All right, now we're getting somewhere. The microphone is being repaired. The Naked Poet is here.
All right, all's well with the world, Tom.
Although I have to say, Naked Poet, you're sure wearing a lot of clothes for Florida. Don't you think it's hot in here?
It's damn hot in here, Tom.
You might want to take some of your clothes off.
I think maybe so, yeah.
I think that'd make it better in here, don't you guys?
Welcome back, Bruce.
Thank you, Michael.
Hey, I'm
Interior. I'm glad to be here.
Who's interior?
Hey, Auntie.
Hey, just so you know, we started right on time at 10 o'clock, but this isn't the show. It's about to be the show. I'm going to do the official welcome for all four of you. I think you'll like it. If you're in the back talking, please talk louder. I can still hear myself. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Gainesville, Florida, home of the Fighting Gators and the Brain Institute. This is the Reverend Angel S. Tabernacle of Edenism, your host, Tom Miller, live in downtown Gainesville, Florida, the University Club. How about that? We got bubbles, we got nacho lighters, we got naked older men, we got everything you've ever want. We got a hurdy-gurdy, we got a guy wearing Angora slippers. You don't know what's going to happen at the show. This is the greatest show you've ever seen. All right, got that out of the way.
We got balloons.
We got balloons, free balloons. Let's blow up some balloons, everybody. Let's have some fun.
Yeah.
Everybody loves balloons.
Use them whatever you want.
Let's get these things going. Get your lips going. Blow these things up. Then we can throw them around. Have a lot of fun. This is great.
Bella's got a knife and pop it.
Yes. Glass of 151 on the rocks, please. Oh, the bartender's gone again. All right.
Bartender needs a balloon. You got a
knob? Did it require welding or what happened?
No, it was a seat.
You just banged it, didn't you? Just banged it on the seat?
Okay.
Give it up for Mello, ladies and gentlemen, an incredible DJ, a technical person, an artist, a poet, a comedian, and he fixes microphones. Thank you very much. All right, did everybody blow up your balloons? Okay. Now I'm feeling like this might be the best show we've ever done at this point. We need to get a lot done already. What do you think? Can I have a glass of 151 on the ice, please? The tall 151 on the ice with a floater of Jägermeister. Do we have 151? I don't know. Wait a minute. Let's find out. Do we have 151? Yeah, I'll have a shot of 151 on ice. If we have 151, I'm drinking it. I want a shot of 151 on ice. Pour a little turkey in there for color.
All right.
That's how I drink. That's how I roll. That is going to really work with Xanax. Man, that's going to be good. Can't wait. Yeah. No offense, we do advocate drugs in here. Not the abuse of drugs, just the creative use of drugs. And everybody has their own dose. Never forget what we say here in the Tabernacle of Hedonism. Right, Reverend? Human beings are chemical interactions. Say no to drugs, say no to life.
Hallelujah.
And that works both ways, if you really think about it.
Hallelujah.
You take too many drugs, you say no to life. And we don't like that either, except that in the afterlife, you get to go to Dubitopia.
That's right.
Smoke all the weed you want. So, you know.
That's right.
Paul Rubens knows.
Yeah.
He's up there jerking off right now in a little theater.
No more Pee Wee Herman, Tom.
Thank you.
What are we going to do?
I call this the Miller. It's a big ham-sized shot of 151 with a dash of 101 proof wild turkey for color. Cheers, everybody. Enjoy.
Woo!
All
right.
Good God, I dropped a ball on that one. All right. Now, let's get some talent up here. I just introduced the acts. I'm like Ed Sullivan on crack. Let's go. Let's rock. Let's get religious. It's a church, anyway. We might as well. We haven't heard from the Reverend Angel Dust at the top of the show like we used to. Let's get back to reality. Let's give you what you need. You need spiritual healing. I know just the man to do it. The one, the only, the Reverend Angel Dust. Give him a round of applause. Here he is for this week's sermon.
All right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Reverend Angel Dust.
God, pray for Pee Wee Herman.
Yes.
Pee Wee Herman needs to pray for us.
Hallelujah.
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 God has blessed everyone. You survived the war on drugs. Be blessed, be happy,
hallelujah.
And be happiest because you are the survivors. Hallelujah. The hypocrites in Washington cannot vanquish the truth of hallucinogens and that which has been conjured by hallucinogens. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Apple Computers, one of the leaders on the New York Stock Exchange, was the product of hallucinogens.
Hallelujah.
In a hot tub up in the mountains.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God has blessed
it. Preach, that's a true story.
Yes, hallelujah. I use IBM, the minister, Deacon, Reverend Tom Miller uses Apple.
Hallelujah.
God has blessed everyone. Without the Apple computer, there would be no Tabernacle of Eden.
There'd be no Tom Miller. It wouldn't exist.
That's right. Without Apple, there would have been no IBM. And there would have been no Microsoft. Hallelujah. That's right. God has blessed everyone. Who is this guy named Pee Wee Herman?
Pee Wee fucking Herman, for God's sakes. He
He was famous.
He was the president of.
Was he the drug dealer in the hole?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think that was the guy who ran drugs into America for Pablo Escobar.
That's correct.
And he made one mistake. They wanted him to do one last round of drug running, and he got arrested. And this shows you that if you are an international drug dealer, you need to deny it.
Great advice.
Even to your friends and people who also helped you run drugs, deny that you ever did it. You see, if the guy in the hole had denied that he was a drug dealer before doing one last run, like his daughter wanted him not to do,
he'd be alive today.
He would not only be alive today, but on be speaking terms with his daughter.
Deduction.
And he would have outlived Pee Wee Herman.
Hallelujah.
God has blessed everyone. That just shows you, if you are a drug dealer, do not admit it. It never happened. Hallelujah.
Great advice.
I never admit to anything with Officer Friendly. When she pulls me over, as she does numerous times, we have an ongoing relationship, I tell her, Jesus did it. I tell her, Jesus is the kingpin. He died for everything, including our drug deals. Hallelujah. Ronald Dump is incident. He is incident because Jesus actually took those files out of the White House and put them in Mar-a-Lago and actually hid them in Mar-a-Lago. But they were boxes.
Because Jesus was the kingpin.
Because Jesus was the kingpin. He was responsible for actually hiding state secrets in Mar-a-Lago. So we pray for Ronald Dump, we pray for his acquittal, and we hope that he gets Baker acted. He will be the first mentally ill president in the history of the United States, or at least diagnosed.
Yeah, diagnosed. Yes.
Diagnosed mentally ill. Hallelujah. I would also like to say that I have been investing in this new bull market on stocks, particularly marijuana stocks. And I've been seeing many, many opportunities in marijuana. One of which is Tilray. Tilray really does not sell drugs in the United States because it's illegal on the federal level. But Tilray is a very popular company because apparently the CEO is top notch and he admits that Tilray is a big risk. So in the last 2 weeks, Tilray has gone up 45%.
Awesome. Great news.
Hallelujah. So I have a Roth IRA, which I get to have because I'm over 40, and that is a tax-free account. And so I bought one share of Tilray for $1.78. Hallelujah. Then I noticed it was going up 41%. So I invested in Tilray on my regular stockbroker's account for $2.45. And that was a limited buy, which means I was hoping it was going to dip from $2.46 to $2.45. But instead, it went up to $2.48. And so
I did a limit share at $2.49.
How much did you make, Robert?
It went up to $2.53 by the end of the day.
That's funny.
So I made 12 cents because I bought 3 shares. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait until the stock rallies, and I've made $1.78, and then I will sell the 3 shares and recoup my $1.78, and that way I will have 1 share of Tilray on my Roth account, which will be tax-free. So if I make any capital gains on that, it's totally tax-free. So Tilray could go up to $1,000. It could go down to 50 cents. I'm just going to hold on to it forever. But I haven't lost anything because I will have made $1.78. Now, you may be asking, what happens if Tilray goes up to, say, 275 and then bullets down to 10 cents?
Yeah, that happens.
What am I going to do? I'm going to sell it at 10 cents and I am going to take advantage of the lost capital. In other words, I'm going to be able to deduct my losses from my taxes at the end of the year. Hallelujah. So I'll be paying less taxes, which will mean more Social Security because I'm self-employed. Nobody in their right mind would hire me. Hallelujah.
Absolutely not.
As I told you, keep listening to Reverend Angel Dust and I will make you a millionaire.
All right. Hallelujah.
Reverend, Rabbi Bath Salts was dumpster diving.
Wow.
Because all the students have left. He came up with a smart TV. He came up with a refrigerator. And he also came up with, most importantly, because he started consuming them immediately, muscadine grapes. Hallelujah. But the muscadine grapes were not in the dumpster. They were growing on a vine. Hallelujah.
It all ties together.
It all ties together. Hallelujah. There's also clean energy. Apparently this is energy which is not fossil fuels. This is ethanol. I don't know if you've heard of E15 / basically 88. And this is 15% ethanol. It's sold at Racetrack in Ocala.
That's what I'm drinking!
That's right. And it burns more efficiently than premium. Then there's E85, which is 85% ethanol. And that doesn't burn as efficiently as E88. Hallelujah. But in Florida, they are coming up with 100% ethanol. Green Thumb is producing it in partnership with unlisted companies, and it's called basically cannabis gas or cannabis fuel, and it's sold. It will be sold at about 20 stations of Circle K. So look at Green Thumb, it's up and coming, and I suspect that the cannabis fuel will be more efficient than premium and E88 combined. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Is this the show?
Yes. I'm helping you pay off your student loans.
Thank you.
Just live out of the dumpster and invest in teal ray options. Hallelujah. And the best kind of options are the ones you think of when you're raiding the dumpster. Hallelujah. Each options trader has their own style. As you can see, I have my own style of trading stocks and bonds. Hallelujah. Any other special prayers?
Bitcoin.
Okay.
Jewels.
What about the marijuana coins?
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, marijuana coins. Special. I built marijuana coins. Hallelujah. Hey,
Reverend, let's have a special prayer for God. I hear he's not doing too well these days.
Who is God?
No, God.
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 God is not doing
too
well.
Yeah, he's not well.
Yeah, maybe he died.
Yeah. They're saying that, but he's not doing too well.
Where's these spears?
Well, God is certainly welcome here in the tabernacle of hedonism. We do worship the goddess, but God is perfectly welcome. Hallelujah.
He needs to get out of that sick bed, you know.
You know, the Bible is a very important document. In the tabernacle of hedonism, Luke chapter 21, verse 27, I think it's verse 11?
That's right.
Yeah, verse 11. Basically, take heed lest any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness. And here in the tabernacle of hedonism, we like to surfeit naked. That's right. If we all were naked, maybe there wouldn't be any war.
Hallelujah.
Special prayers to the Ukrainian chatterbait models who are encouraging everybody to get naked and are critical of both the Russian and Ukrainian government.
Hallelujah.
As you know, they are bombing each other at this point.
If everybody was naked, there would be no more war.
Naked on chatterbait with Ukrainian models, they wouldn't have time for the war. Hallelujah. Well, you know, it would be tasteful nudity, not fluidity. Hallelujah. God has blessed everyone. Any other special, you know, I mean, if the Ukrainian models are not doing it, who else is?
Right.
Hallelujah. God bless everyone.
Britney Spears. Yes.
Britney Spears is a nudist.
That's right.
Hallelujah. God bless everyone. Any other special prayers? Amy Gibson. She's a nudist too, I think. She must be in her 60s or 50s. Hallelujah.
Paul Rubin.
Hallelujah.
Pee-wee
Herman. Hallelujah. Any other special prayers?
Sinead O'Connor.
Yeah! Sinead O'Connor.
She died. Hallelujah. Was she a nudist? The comedian back there says, yes, she was a nudist. So she was part of the tabernacle, or at least reflecting the tabernacle ideas. Preaching peace was a pacifist. You think so? Hallelujah. God has blessed everyone. Our mother.
Who groweth.
The greatest green.
Non-corporate.
Up there in the Ojambosphere. Under the influence of the domestic they trim up there. Oh, heavenly is that herb. Oh, high and holy is the great dumpster mother. Officer friendly.
Please forgive me.
I drove into the ditch because I forgot to put on my safety belts. Aside from that, the Amber Alert said that they gave the kid to the straight person and not the stoner.
That's right.
And that was very upsetting. Please search my car. I'm innocent. If you find anything suspicious, that's right, and I will testify to this in a court of law, adjudicated, vindicated, and hopefully be corrected, which means more lithium. Hallelujah. Xanax and ecstasy. Hallelujah. And medical marijuana. The more the merrier, for thine is the kalpi, the rain and the shroom. Amen.
Amen.
A1.
A1.
A Pee Wee Herman.
A Pee Wee Herman.
A Sammy Ann O'Connor. A Circle K gas station with the hemp fuel option.
Circle K gas station with the hemp fuel option.
We believe in options.
We believe in options.
For Pope Francis too.
A joint. God bless everyone. Hallelujah.